Okay, welcome again, student. Here we'll discussing with the part one of the chapter two, which is on polynomial. Okay, now before going to discuss on this part, let us know some of the definition of a polynomial. Let us learn about the definition of a polynomial. An algebraic expression of the form px equal a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 go on decreasing, the power go on increasing in this way till the last term being a 0, where a 0, a 1, a2 up to an are all the real numbers, an does not equal 0, and n being a positive integer is called a polynomial in the variable x. Okay, that means if you find any of the algebraic expression which is in this form where there is a coefficient a n x to the power n, mean n, it can be any positive integers. This power n x power n, this n here should can be any positive integers. Okay, and if you find the expression in this form, we can say that this is a polynomial in which variable? In variable x. Why? Because the variable involved in this given expression is x. That's why it is a polynomial in x. Okay. In this given polynomial, in this expression px equal a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 and so on, the last term is 0. The terms of polynomial mean a n x power n, this is one term, mean each and every term they are being separated either by plus sign or minus sign. Okay, and here in this polynomial is all the term are being connected with plus a n x n plus a n minus 1 x n minus 1 plus a n minus 2 x n minus 2 plus and so on. Okay, these are the terms of a polynomial, and the coefficient are a n is the coefficient of x n, a n minus 1 is the coefficient of x n minus 1, a 1 is the coefficient of x, and a0 is the coefficient of whom? Here a1 x power 1, a0 x power 0. This means a0 is the coefficient of x power 0, but x power 0 is 1. This means a0 can also be term as a constant term. And the variable involved here is x. That's why we are calling as a polynomial in x, in the variable x. Suppose if the variable is y, you can say that this is the polynomial in variable y. Okay, now let us familiarize with a polynomial. In this table I've shown some of the polynomial, and let us identify the number of term, the coefficient of x squared, coefficient of x, and the constant term. Okay, 2x squared minus 3x plus 1, how many terms are there? Just I've said that each term is being connected with the other term either with plus or minus sign. 2x squared minus 3x plus 1, that means 2x squared is one term, 3x is one term, and 1 is another term. That means we have 3 terms in this given polynomial. Okay, the coefficient of x squared, what is the coefficient of x squared? It is 2. 2 is the coefficient of x squared. Coefficient of x, it is minus 3. And the constant is 1. In the second example, 5x square minus 2x. How many terms they are? 2 terms. Coefficient x square is 5. Coefficient of x, it is minus 2. And the constant, is there any constant? No. And therefore, what should be constant? Constant mean is not associated with any x. If is associated with x, then that is called coefficient of x. If it associated with x squared, that is called coefficient of x squared. Constant is just a number. Here is there is no such constant, but you can write a constant as 0. Why? Because this can also be written as 5x squared minus 2x plus 0. Okay, then the constant here is 0. Why we are not writing this? If I write like this, that means the number of them is 3, isn't it? Number of them is 3, but 0 is not counted. Why? Because if you add 0, the value remain the same. That means the polynomial remain the same. 5x squared minus 2x and 5x squared minus 2x plus 0 is the same. That means there is no meaning of adding 0 here. Okay, that's why the constant is 0, or we can be written as there is no constant term in this given polynomial. Okay, with the number 3, and the number 3x squared minus 5x minus 1, the number of terms, they are how many? They are 3 terms. Okay, coefficient x squared definitely is 3. Coefficient of x, it is minus 5. Constant, it is minus 1. Okay, are you clear with this? Which are the coefficient of x squared? Which are the coefficient of x, which is a constant? And how many terms are there? You can just have a look on this table I've shown to you. If any real number which is associated with x squared will be the coefficient of x squared. With x, it is the coefficient of x. And if it's just a real number, that will be a constant. Okay. Same thing with the next also. And the last one, I'll just show you the last. X squared minus 1. How many terms? There are 2 terms. Coefficient of x squared, it is 1. Why? Because x square here you have there is only x square. Why we are taking 1? Because duo is not written here, but we can assume the coefficient of x to be 1, because 1 multiply x square is how much? 1 multiply x square is x square itself, isn't it? Therefore the coefficient of x square here is 1. Coefficient of x, there is no x. We can take coefficient of x to be 0, and constant term is minus 1. Why we are taking coefficient of x as 0? See, this x squared minus 1 can be written as x squared plus 0x minus 1. 0 multiply x is how much? 0. That mean it's half no value. You'll have only x squared minus 1 only, isn't it? But if they ask you what is the coefficient of x in x squared minus 1, definitely you can see that the coefficient of x is 0. I think you are clear with the coefficient of x squared, coefficient of x and a constant. Okay, now we move to the next, which is on the degree of a polynomial. What is the degree of polynomial? The highest power of x in the polynomial Px is called the degree of the polynomial Px. If a polynomial is in variable y, therefore the highest power of y in that polynomial will be called as the degree of the polynomial. Now here I've given you an example. If Px equal 3x plus 5, what should be the degree of this? You look for the highest power of the variable 3x. X is the variable. What is the power of x here? X is having the power of 1. Okay, if there is no power, then we can assume that it is having a power of 1, because if is x to power 1 mean x power 1 mean x only. Okay, and this polynomial is having a degree of 1. Now, a constant polynomial. What is a constant polynomial? A polynomial of degree 0 is called a constant polynomial. Why degree is 0? Just look at this degree of polynomial. If x is having the power 0, then what will happen? If x is having power 0, x to power 0 is 1. Any real number to the power 0 is 1. If I write 2 to power 0, what is the 2 to power 0? 2 power 0 is 1. 2 power 1, 2. 2 power 2, 4. Clear? 2 power 2 is 4. 2 power 1 is 2. 2 power 0 is 1. Any real number raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Now here, a constant polynomial is a polynomial of degree 0. Clear? Px equal 5. Px equal 5. What is the power of x here? Power of x here is 0. Just because x power, if we write x here, x power 0 is 1. 5 multiply 1 is 5 only. Okay. Such type of polynomial, they can be termed as a constant polynomial. Suppose if I write px equal 10, is it that a polynomial? The answer will be yes. If px equal 10, that is a polynomial, which is also a called as a constant polynomial. Next, zero polynomial. What is zero polynomial? A constant polynomial px equals 0 is called a zero polynomial. If a polynomial px equals 0, then that is called as a constant polynomial. Mean here, if px equals 5, py equal, px constant polynomial mean just only a number. If p of x is just only a number, px equal 2, px equal 3, px equal 4, that is a constant polynomial. But if a constant polynomial is 0, that will be called as a 0 polynomial. If px equal 0 is not a constant polynomial, it is a 0 polynomial. Or if py equals 0, it is not a constant polynomial, it is a 0 polynomial. If you have any other number, any number other than 0, if px equal 1, px equal 2, px equal 3, all they are the constant. But if px equals 0, it is a 0 polynomial. Are you clear? What is a constant and zero polynomial? If px equals 0, that is called a zero polynomial. Now next we move, let us learn on here on the degree of a polynomial. Now if a polynomial px is given to be 2x minus 3, then what should be the degree? What we just now I've discussed with you, what is the degree? Degree is the highest power of x in that polynomial. 2x minus 3, 3 is a constant. X is here. What is the power of x here? If not given, then you should take as a power 1. Therefore, this polynomial is having a degree of 1. and the name of this polynomial will be a linear polynomial. Now, if we, in the second example, if px equal 5x square minus 2x plus 1, what will be degree of this? In the first term, x is having power 2, second term, x is having power 1, and in the last term, x is having power 0. Then which is the highest among all these power of x? Highest is 2, therefore the degree will be 2, and such type of polynomial will be called as a quadratic polynomial. Means, any polynomial of degree 2 is always a quadratic polynomial. Any polynomial of degree 1 is always a linear polynomial. Next, we have with the example px equal to x cubed plus 3x squared plus 5x plus 7. Now, what will be the degree? What will be the degree means what will be the highest power of x in the given polynomial. Now, here in the first term, x is having power 3, second term, x is having power of 2, third term, x is having power of 1, isn't it? Which is the highest? Highest is 3, and such polynomial will be called as a cubic polynomial. Means, any polynomial of degree 3 is called a cubic. And the same thing, any polynomial of degree 4 will be called as a biquadratic polynomial. Now, coming to the next, we have a zero of a polynomial. What is a zero of a polynomial? A real number alpha is called zero of the polynomial px if p of alpha is equal to 0. Okay, if the value of p alpha is equal to 0, then that value of alpha, that value will be called as the zero of the polynomial. In this example, 2 is the zero of this polynomial px equal x minus 2. Why? Because if you substitute the value of x by 2, if you write p2, then this will become 2 minus 2. 2 minus 2 is how much? 0. That means p of 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, 2 will be called as the 0 of a polynomial. Okay, are you clear? 2 will be called, this number 2, this real number 2 will be called as a 0. It is the 0, this 2 is the 0 of the given, of this polynomial. Okay, second example, minus half is the 0 of the polynomial py. If you substitute y by minus half, what will become? Minus half plus half, 0. Py is called 0, then this value of y is the 0 of a polynomial. In general, if alpha is the 0 of px equal ax plus b, then p of alpha will be equal 0, which implies that a alpha plus b equals 0. Substitute the value of x by alpha, a alpha plus b equals 0. A alpha equal, take b to right side, is minus b. Therefore, alpha will be minus b by a. Clear? You just transpose this b to right side. After that, you divide minus b by a. You will get the value of alpha. Alpha equal minus b by a. Hence, the zero of a linear polynomial, linear why? Because the degree is 1. Okay? Because here is having degree of 1, that's why we are calling linear. Hence, the zero of a linear polynomial Px equal Ax plus b is minus b by a. What is? What is b? A constant. What is a? Quotient of x. Minus the constant divided by quotient of x. Next, we have value of a polynomial. What is the value of polynomial? Let Px be a polynomial and alpha be a real number, then P of alpha is the value of the polynomial where x equal alpha. Okay, x equal alpha. Here, we have discussed zero of a polynomial. If you substitute x by alpha equal zero, then that alpha will be called as a zero. But here, if you substitute the value of x by alpha, that alpha will be, P of alpha will be the value of the polynomial. If you find out P of alpha, you will get, maybe you will get other number. Sometimes you can get zero, or sometimes you will not get zero. But P of alpha is the value of the polynomial. Now, here in the example, if Px equal x square minus 3x plus 5, the value of polynomial. If the question asks, find the value of a polynomial at x equal to 0. Suppose, if Px of, what will be the value of P0? Okay, what will be P value of P0? Mean what will be the value of this polynomial if alpha is equal, if x equals 0? If x equals 0, then this polynomial will be x square, mean 0 square minus 3, 0 plus 5. Substitute the value of x by 0. Okay. Why? Because we are finding the value of p0. Now 0 square is 0, 3 multiplied 0 is 0, plus 5. You will have only 5. Okay. Now if they ask, find the value of p1 in the given polynomial. Now, what will be the value of P1? P1 will be, substitute the value of x here by 1. 1 square minus 3 multiply 1 plus 5. 1 square is 1, 3 multiply 1 is 3 plus 5. Then 5 and 1, they are positive. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 minus 3, you are getting 3. This means the value of this polynomial, the value of P1, it is 3. The value of P0, it is 5. Let us find the value of this polynomial of at P2. The value of P2 is how much? Same thing, you will substitute the value of this polynomial. Instead of x, you are putting the by 2. This means 2 square minus 3 multiply 2 plus 5. 2 square is how much? 2 multiply 2, 4. Minus 3 multiply 2, 6. Then plus 5. 5 and 4, they are positive. You can add them. 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 minus 6, it is 3. Okay. You are getting the value of P1 is 3. Value of P2 is 3. Sometimes it can be the same. Sometimes it may differ also. It does not matter. But we are finding the value of a polynomial. Clear? Next, geometrical meaning of zero of a polynomial. What it does is mean by zero of a polynomial if we represent in a graph paper. If we represent that polynomial in a graph paper, how will it look like? What does it mean by the zero polynomial when we draw on a graph paper? Okay, I'll just show you here on a table that a linear polynomial, if we draw the graph of a linear polynomial, the zero of this polynomial of linear polynomial will be the point where it touches the graph on the x-axis, where the zero of a polynomial is the number of points where the graph of that polynomial touches the x-axis. Linear polynomial, if you draw the graph of linear polynomial, will be always a straight line, and a straight line will always touch the x-axis at only one point. That means there will be only one zero of a linear polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. If you draw the graph of a quadratic polynomial, you'll find that it touches the x-axis at two points, which means that a quadratic polynomial will always have two zeros or two point where it touch the x-axis. Okay, what does it mean by zeros of a polynomial? Zeros of a quadratic polynomial is the point where it touch the axis. Mean a quadratic polynomial will always have two zeros. That mean two point where it touch the axis. And the same way, the cubic polynomial will touch the axis at three points. Okay. Next, we come to the relationship between zero and coefficient of a polynomial. If alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial, quadratic, why? Because having degree of 2, okay? Px equal ax squared plus bx plus c. This is the standard form of a quadratic polynomial. Remember this standard form of a quadratic polynomial. This is the standard form of a quadratic polynomial. Ax squared plus bx plus c. What is a? A is a coefficient of x squared. What is b? B is coefficient of x. And what is c? C is a constant. Now, if alpha and beta are the zero of the quadratic polynomial, why alpha and beta? Why are these two zero are there? Just now we have discussed the graphical representation of a quadratic polynomial should touch the x-axis at two points. Therefore, a quadratic polynomial should have two zeros. Clear? Now, if alpha and beta are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial, then the sum of zeros will be the first and the second zero, alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is given by this formula, minus b by a, minus of b. What is b? B is coefficient of x. What is a? A is coefficient of x squared. Sum of zeros is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x squared. And the product of zeros mean alpha multiply with beta. Alpha beta equals c by a. What is c? Is constant term. What is a? Coefficient of x squared. Constant divided by coefficient of x squared. Okay, now these are the two important relationship between these zeros and the coefficient of a polynomial, of a quadratic. Here we are discussing regarding with a quadratic polynomial. Now these are the two formulas that you should remember. We will come so many time with this formula. Now this just remember these two formulas. Sum of zeros in a quadratic polynomial is minus b by a. What is b? B is coefficient of x. What is a? A is coefficient of x squared. And the product of zeros is c by a. What is c? A constant term. What is a? Coefficient of x squared. B by a minus b by a, c by a. Okay. You note down these two formula. Will be using so many time with this, the sum of 0, what is the sum of 0, product of 0 in a quartic polynomial. Okay, for the time we will stop here and we'll continue again on our next class. Bye to all of you.